We take pictures before it's wrecked, and not only after, but we take it as we're putting the parts on. All done to above industry standards. So I'm proud of our body shop, too. Don't forget our parts department. So you know, if you happen to need parts, performance parts, or just parts if you're a weekend mechanic.
Woody Anderson Ford, located at the corner of Jordan and Sparkman, as well as Hughes Road and Madison. You can also check out the great deals at WoodyAndersonFord.com.
In today's fast-paced real estate market, information is everything. Former charger and local agent David Ivey offers a fresh, innovative approach that he combines with unrivaled technology and amazing personal service. If you are thinking about buying or selling in the Huntsville area, contact David Ivey at IveyHSV.com. That's IveyHSV.com.
Hey, this is Bob Baumhauer here to let you know that something's cooking. Many of y'all know me as that crazy jock that brought buffalo-style chicken wings to Alabama way back when. Turns out we were way ahead of the curve and things changed. Now I'm here to tell you that you're in for another surprise. As a guy who played for Coach Bryant and Don Shula, you got to know it's going to be a winner. Stay tuned and visit us at Baumhauers.com or become a fan on Facebook. You never know who's going to get some free tickets.
97.7 The Zone.
Getting ready for the men, which is scheduled now to tip it up in 22 minutes as we are closing things out as Christian Brothers, a winner over UAH. 63-62 is that final score as Lytle hits a game-winning three at the end of regulation to help propel the Buccaneers for a road victory here in Huntsville.
Yeah, Coach Baldwin still has yet to make her way into the locker room to visit with the team. So we're still waiting to hear from her. But Steve, I tell you what, that's a tough way to win. It's never great to lose, but when you have to lose like that, that's a tough one.
It is, especially considering the fact that the fourth quarter, you really felt like we were in control of most of that fourth quarter.
Well, and they had did a great job. I know Lytle, you know, to that point had 19 points, but, you know, really she had not hurt them from behind the arc. She had gotten to the lane a few times. I mean, it was a quiet 19 points, and just, you know, one play just kind of let her, you know, you let your defense kind of drift a little bit and leave her open in that corner. And, I mean, she's such a great shooter that really, I mean, one shot, I mean, that's it. I mean, they gave her one really good three today, and it's right at the end of the ballgame.
And they made the most of their opportunity. There's no doubt about it. The men's team on both sides for CBU and UAH looking a little different, not necessarily on the floor, but on the sidelines. Two new head coaches for both men's programs heading into this season, as Coach John Riley is the man leading the charge for the Buccaneers and Coach John Shulman for UAH. So one of the two of the longer tenured coaches in the Gulf South Conference, as Coach Nienaber is now at Delta State. And, of course, we know Coach Lenny Acuff, the head man in charge at Lipscomb. And both programs still very, very solid. Chargers at 11-2, but 3-2 rather in the Gulf South Conference. Well, Christian Brothers is 5-7, and that may be a bit deceiving because they are 2-3 in the Gulf South Conference. So they are still very much in the thick of the race here at the beginning of January. Let's go ahead and take a timeout. We'll hear from Coach Baldwin. Then we'll hear from Coach Shulman as you listen to Charger Basketball on 97.7 The Zone.
This is Wes Neighbors talking to Chris Haygood of Bob Wallace Appliance. Chris, what sets you apart from other appliance dealerships?
Wes, these appliances are going into the most used room in your house, your kitchen. The way we have these appliances displayed, it's easy for you to visualize how they'll look in your home. Wes, what sets us apart is the people. They're well-trained. In fact, they live and breathe these appliances. And if you need service, you'll really appreciate our parts department.
Contact Bob Wallace Appliance at 256-533-2121.
Tom Luganbill here for Woody Anderson Ford. When I was in the Tennessee Valley, one of the things that impressed me the most was the quality of the people. People like Bobby White and his team at Woody Anderson Ford. And now you can experience the tremendous new service lanes and showroom at Woody Anderson Ford, at Jordan and Sparkman, or just stop by for breakfast or lunch at Henry's Mustang Cafe. And in Madison, visit Woody Anderson of Madison on Hughes Road, just south of 72. Like a great college football tradition, always there, Woody Anderson Ford.
97.7 The Zone.
Game one in the books, getting ready for game two of three here this Saturday afternoon here on 97.7 The Zone. Pre-game warm-ups continue for both teams. Chargers coming off of a win on Thursday, a 12-point victory, a hard-fought win over the Bulldogs of Tennessee Wesleyan, 76-64. In those pregame warm-ups, Ryan McDaniel went down with what looked like a pretty gruesome ankle injury. Happy to report that Ryan was released that very night after they reset his ankle. There were no broken bones on that left ankle, but he is going to get an MRI on Monday. And there's no doubt that there is probably some ligament damage there in that ankle for Ryan McDaniel. A little less than 17 minutes away from tip-off here between UAH and CBU.
Well, yeah, Steve, we're just waiting for Coach Baldwin. She just walked into the locker room and had a chance to visit with the team, so we're just letting her take a chance to talk to the ladies and obviously, you know, try to get them back on track. And, you know, I tell you what, it's kind of heartbreak for the UAH Chargers on the women's side, Steve. The last two games have come down to the wire, you know, that they take a very good Union team to double overtime before falling. And then here against Christian Brothers, that goes all the way down to the wire. And both of those games, UAH led late, and, it was Union having to shoot the ball late to tie in both games there, and same way here. So, I mean, it's tough. I mean, you look at your record now, and, you know, you're an eyelash away from having two wins at home.
Instead, taking a look at a .500 record. So, I mean, how different from 3-3 to 4-1, or what would that be, 5-1? So different moving forward, but you're absolutely right. Just tough to think about, but it really does show what kind of team, what kind of talent is on this team as well for UIH. A lot of talent at the point or the guard position, as well as a lot of talent at the five position as well. We saw it went three deep in this game.
Yeah, it did. And, you know, if you look at UAH, I mean, I know at the beginning of the day, you look at it and you say, okay, Katie Spiegel and Adrian Grant, we're going to count on you as fives down low. I want you know, there was a lot of opportunities early in the game for both Spiegel and Grant to get touches and get some points. And then when Katie goes into foul trouble, you know, Grant has to have some extended minutes. And you look at Adrian Grant, you know, she played over 11 and a half minutes today. Katie Spiegel played 18. Alexis Woods, 9.5 minutes. And so for Alexis Woods, that 9.5 minutes, I mean, she gave UAH some quality minutes, 11 points, 5 rebounds. That's a good production from your third five, which you didn't count on getting.
We'll hopefully hear from Coach Baldwin right after this word from Neighbors Wealth Management.
Do you plan on retiring one day? Are you worried about market losses and how they may affect your future? Did you know it only takes 2 consecutive years of market losses to completely derail a retirement plan? What if there were a way to get a decent return with minimal risk? At Neighbors Wealth Management, we'll show you how this is possible and what you can do to make sure your retirement stays on track. Give us a call, 256-469-2324. That's Neighbors Wealth Management, 256-469-2324, or online at neighborswealthmanagement.com. These days, many folks retire not knowing exactly how taxes work on Social Security and retirement accounts. They find out way too late in the game, needlessly losing money to taxes they could have easily avoided with just a little bit of expert guidance. At Neighbors Wealth Management, we can show you easy steps that you can take to reduce taxes in your retirement. Give us a call at 256-469-2324. That's Neighbors Wealth Management, 256-469-2324, or online at neighborswealthmanagement.com.
97.7 The Zone.
Coming up here momentarily in my conversation with Coach Shulman, which is brought to you by Ivy Realtor. In fact, David Ivy, a former UAH Charger and former assistant coach as well, can now hook you up here in this market. If you're in the market for a home, it's ivyhsv.com. Chargers enter into the contest at 11-2, 3-2 in Gulf South Conference play. Christian Brothers at 5-7 and 2-3 in the Gulf South Conference. The standings heading into this afternoon's contest, Montevallo, the last undefeated team left in conference play. They are 4-0. Lee is at 4-1. West Alabama is at 3-1. Then both UAH, Valdosta State, Union are all at 3-2. Delta State is at 2-2. West Georgia also at 2-2. CBU and West Florida are both at 2-3. Auburn, Montgomery, and Mississippi College are at 1-4. And Shorter is the lone team that has yet to register a conference victory so far this season. Your conference schedule for the day includes Valdosta State at West Alabama. That should be interesting. Union is at Lee. The Warhawks of Auburn Montgomery are at undefeated Montevallo. Shorter is at Mississippi College. And West Georgia is at Delta State. So there is a lot of really interesting matchups today in the Gulf South Conference.
All right, Steve, we do now have Coach Baldwin with us. Coach, you take control in the fourth a little bit, and then what a way to end a ball game. I know that that's a tough way. What did you tell the ladies in the locker room?
I told them, first of all, to keep their head up. I thought our effort was very, very good tonight, just across the board. We really made some big plays. We took a lot of good charges that we've kind of been missing out on. So some really unselfish play there. We've just got to get better at end-of-the-clock situational defense. That's happened to us the past two games where a team's hitting threes at the end of the clock. So we'll work on that. And a little bit that kind of shifted our balance a little bit is that we've got to have someone step up in our point guard position other than our starting point guard. And that just comes from maturity and just getting more reps in practice and us instilling confidence in them. But we've just got to get better from the bench a little bit and then just across the board. But hate the way.
Well, speaking of the bench, Alexis Woods, a performance from her.
Absolutely. Lex, we know the capability of Lex. Unfortunately, she's been sick this week, so she didn't get to play on Thursday. But she came in ready tonight, and I'm super proud. She played 9 minutes, had 11 points, some big rebounds. When Katie Spiegel just started out a little bit slow, but Katie ended up finishing the game well, too. So yeah. Really proud of all of our post players. They did a really good job tonight across the board. So we're just going to continue to get better and hopefully get the next one again Shorter on Thursday.
I know we got a lot of people listening. Have you had a chance to talk to Coach Lemon at all? And a lot of people just want an update.
Absolutely. I haven't got to talk to her today just because everything with her family. I'm hoping to call her right after this, maybe tonight at some point after everything kind of settles down with her family issues and everything. Talked to her yesterday. She seemed in good spirits. But just to continue to pray for her and her family, just comfort and peace as they're dealing through this difficult time. And we're excited to have her back for sure.
All right, Coach. Well, wish it would have ended better, but we're going to press on, and now we press on the road.
Yes, sir.
There you have it, Steve.
Thank you very much, Scott Tyson. My conversation with Coach John Shulman as we get ready now for the second half of this doubleheader here at home. If you're in the neighborhood, come on by. My conversation with Coach Shulman brought to you by David Ivy Realty.
Yeah, down to tip off here with head coach John Shulman, getting ready for conference play the rest of the way is Christian Brothers comes into town here today. Congratulations on the win over Tennessee Wesleyan, Coach. Tell me your thoughts on that win. I know there was a lot involved pregame all the way to the end.
What a crazy night. I mean, what an insane night. And I told the guys right before the game, sometimes life gets in the way. And life got in the way of that basketball game. And that's okay because it's at the end of it, I said basketball game, it's a game. And, you know, they saw one of their teammates and one of their brothers. I've never been around a group as close as this bunch. I mean, it's ridiculous how close. When they say they're brothers, they are brothers. And when they see Ryan McDaniel go down in a very gruesome way, it affected them. We had guys in tears in the locker room. When you got guys in tears in the locker room, and then what are you supposed to do? Go in there and give a rah-rah speech? Hey, man, let's go. You know, so it was, let's, you know, Ryan, as he's laying there, was not worried about Ryan. Ryan's worried about, hey, coach, I'm worried about our guys because they're going to see this and it's going to affect them. And hey, man, let's just move on. Let's you focus on Ryan and we'll try to focus on that game. But it's a very difficult game to play, number one, right before conference play. And then you add that to it. And then they played a little 1-3-1 and really caused us some problems until late in the game. Thank goodness Max and TC made some shots to kind of buy us some time, but we kind of figured it out late in the game and got some good stuff late in the game. I wasn't real pleased defensively, but the numbers show that we weren't horrible. You know, you give up, 63 or 65 points, I guess, to them, and ranked top 10 in the country defensively. It was just one of those nights that's a lot better than talking about after getting a win. It could have been an L, and it wasn't. We dug deep and figured out a way and got enough stops and got to win. They played a different D and played a little matchup 1-3-1 that we hadn't seen a whole lot. We just figured it out late. But the nice thing is we did figure it out. And the nice thing is if people do that again to us, we know what to do.
Tell me about turnover-wise. Well, what did you see on the film in terms of turnovers?
Just different defense. It got us standing. It got us standing. We're used to moving and moving and moving that ball, and it got us standing. And then all of a sudden, when we didn't get enough stops early, because when a team plays that type of zone, if you can get stops, you can go attack before they get the D set. Mm-hmm. Well, we end up throwing the ball in bounds every single time, and then we had to play against that set 1-3-1. Got us standing, and once you don't have success on it early, it gets you a little unsure, and we were unsure, and we played the game unsure, and we played the game tight, and we got tighter as the game went on. That's why I was really thrilled with Max and TC making some shots in some tough situations, which they need to do, and we got enough stops, and here we are 11-2, getting ready to play Christian Brothers.
Well, and it feels like a really important game on the schedule because we got a 3-game road trip coming up, Coach, and a chance to grab some momentum before that road trip.
Yeah, we've won 3 in a row. I'm not sure about Sam Orff today as we're talking about it right now. He's still up in the air. We need Sam. But we also, you know, it's nice to have TC back with the ability to make some shots. I will tell you this, we had a great day of practice yesterday. We had a great, our mindset is really good. You know, it's not a secret. JJ's struggling a little bit, but we are, and we talked about it. We don't hide it and put it over in the side of the room. Man, we need JJ Kaplan to be JJ Kaplan, and he struggled a little bit. Here, the deal is, this is the second year of being J.J. Kaplan. First year, nobody knew him, and he could give a rip. He scored about 2 points a game, and redshirt freshman. The next year, he came on and had an unbelievable year. And now he's the first guy that people talk about on the scouting report. So it changes. He just got to get back and be J.J., play hard, go rebound the ball, and good things will happen to him. And he had a really good day yesterday, and I'm excited to kind of watch him kind of get out of this. You know, we've talked about this. Everybody needs to be on top of the mountain, and everybody needs to be in the valley. And if you don't ever go in the valley, you can't appreciate the mountaintop. And he's in the valley right now. And when he gets back on that mountaintop and I see that smile again, it's gonna be a good day for us.
Well, another kid that made me think of that conversation was how big were the minutes we got from Kearney Lane and the amount of rebounds that he gathered in that win.
Well, I think Kearney's been one of our just more consistent guys this year. His improvement from last year to this year has been drastic. But I will put out that I'm just going to tell you, DB made a couple big plays for us late in that game. And we don't talk about DB enough. DB is that unsung hero that, you know, in the Princeton offense, he's the point guard. Yeah. And Kearney's the point guard. And DB will play a whole game and not score a lot, but dadgum, he is valuable to our success. So DB and Kearney both made some big plays late in that game to help us pull through. Chris and brothers been a pain in the tail for UAH for many, many, many years. Mm-hmm. They are really good defensively. They are sound and solid offensively. New coach over there, new coach over here. It'll be a war. It'll be a battle. You know, I mean, they're 2-3 in the league, and we're 3-2. It's a separating game.
It really is, Coach. So tell me a key or two for a win here this afternoon.
Well, we've got to – it's, you know, we played against that 1-3-1, and that hurts your flow. We had no flow. But that's the point of playing zone, is it hurts flow. I think we're going to see 40 minutes of man-to-man D. That's what they pride themselves on, and we pride ourselves on our man-to-man O. So that will be good for our basketball team, I think, to have some flow. So hopefully if they can play some man, if they play man the whole time, we have good flow offensively, run and attack. Even though they're really good and sound defensively, we're really good and sound offensively. And then we just got to – Miller, I would think, is the key. Miller, we can't let Miller make 5-6 threes. And so we have – two different ways to play shooters. We call them Kimbas for Kemba Walker, who is a good three-point shooter, and we call them Corvers, who is a great three-point shooter. We're going to start in our Kemba coverage. Kemba means that he doesn't get threes, but we're going to make it look like we're playing our regular sound, solid man-to-man D. Corver, if he makes a couple, we'll go to Corver, or we'll deny him and face guard him all around the court. It will look like a box and one for you. It is not a box and one. It's a man and one. And so we'll play our regular man and just take him away. But he's a guy that we cannot let get off.
Finally, Coach, it'll be good to see Ryan back in the building. I know he's excited to be back in the building for today's game, just as a spectator, by the way.
Well, we talked yesterday, and he was like, Coach, I mean, he's sitting there apologizing for not coming to practice. I was like, don't come to practice. Don't come to shoot around. Just our team needs you at the game. And you know, with Coach Palmer in a walker with his – I mean, we're going to have a whole section. With Sam hurt and Riley was hurt, we're going to have a whole section. We'll have a handicap section down there on the court. But it'll be great to have him. You know, he's a sweet kid. He's a team-first kid. And to have him back on that court and to have him help us and root for us, I think will be peace of mind for our kids.
Good luck today, Coach.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
That is my conversation with head coach John Shulman, brought to you by David Ivy Realtor. And speaking of Ryan, I mean, if anything, he's cramping the style of Scott Tyson because he's on the medical table back there. And that's usually the spot that Scott Tyson takes during the game. So Scott's going to be a little cramped here this afternoon, but he'll make room. There's no doubt about that. Both teams head to their respective sidelines and starting lineups. Opening tip here this afternoon is next.
In today's fast-paced real estate market, information is everything. Former Charger and local agent David Ivy offers a fresh, innovative approach that he combines with unrivaled technology and amazing personal service. If you are thinking about buying or selling in the Huntsville area, contact David Ivy at ivyhsv.com. That's ivyhsv.com.
Hey, this is Bob Baumhauer here to let you know that something's cooking. Many of y'all know me as that crazy jock that brought buffalo-style chicken wings to Alabama way back when. Turns out we were way ahead of the curve and things changed. Now I'm here to tell you that you're in for another surprise. As a guy who played for Coach Bryant and Don Shula, you got to know it's going to be a winner. Stay tuned and visit us at Baumhauers.com or become a fan on Facebook. You never know who's going to get some free tickets.
97.7 The Zone.
Our countdown to tip-off is presented by the South Memorial Chick-fil-A, where they encourage you to eat more chicken. Let's go through the starting lineups. What do you got for me, Scott?
See, it's kind of funny down here. You know, Ryan McDaniel is spending time here on the training table, and before every starting lineup, they have certain rituals where they go through certain handshakes, and with Ryan back, the players are coming over to the training table with Ryan not able to move and still trying to do the secret handshake. And it's pretty funny how they're trying to include him as a part of this, you know, group, and they're just glad to have him back.
Let's roll through the starting lineup first for the visiting Buccaneers from Christian Brothers under head coach John T. Riley in his first season at the helm. They will go with Aiden Rudsalt. Also, Daryl Lewis getting the start along with Tyler Hames, Joshua Jackson, and we heard a lot about Brad Miller, who is back at CBU yet again, as Miller, the senior out of Cincinnati, Ohio. Now for the UAH Chargers under head coach John Shulman, also in his first year. We will counter with the same starting five that we had on Thursday with Malik Cook-Stroop, Tristan Chambers, Seth Suave, J.J. Kaplan, and Dalton Barkley. Chargers come out in the home white unis with blue letters and numbers, while CBU will counter with those familiar road red with white letters and numbers.
Well, Steve, look for Christian Brothers early on to try to set that tone offensively. They're going to want to run multiple sets every time they have that ball. Whether they don't get the first look, they're going to put it up, running multiple sets. UAH is going to have to play multiple defenses tonight. It's going to be a big key.
Tip goes to CBU as we tip it up here on a Saturday afternoon. A little half-court trap has Miller at it mid-court. Bounce pass underneath, thrown away, but it went off of a UAH player with 18 on the shot clock. Miller to plug it in. Just 13 seconds gone into this opening half. Inbounds it goes. Rudsalt moves it around the arc. Both teams play a similar style offense. Miller pump fakes a three. Rudsalt for three ball, and it's no good. Rebounded by J.J. Kaplan. J.J., who's been in a bit of a funk, sends it up ahead to Barkley, and a walking violation on DB turns it right back over to CBU. Both teams with a possession. Neither team has scored here early in this one. Ball tipped and stolen away by TC. Chambers sends it up ahead to Malik, powers his way up. Scoop layup rolls in for Malik. And a 30-second timeout is taken by CBU very early, as we've only played 49 seconds into this opening half, and the Chargers out to an early 2-0 lead. I wonder what Coach Riley saw that made him want to burn a timeout that early.
Well, Steve, I think it's the pressure that UAH started with. They came out with a little half-court trap on the tip, and on that make, every make that UAH makes tonight, the plan is to go with a little pressure, and I think Christian Brothers probably either wasn't ready for it or wanted to take some time to figure out how to deal with it, because after that tip, they kind of hurried up their offense possession just a little bit.
Off the timeout, full court press. Rudsalt's with it, sends it over to Miller, skips it across the timeline, driving it. Ball stolen away by Tristan Chambers. Chambers in the other direction, layup off the glass, no good, rebounded by Miller. It stays a two-point lead for UAH. Rudsalt rolls it on underneath. Hayes, his bounce pass stolen away by Dalton Barkley. Quickly back with it comes Suave over to Malik. Open three. Yes, sir. Malik Cook-Stroop. That is his 13th made three of the year. And it's a 5-0 early lead here for the Chargers. Holding it out on the wing there is Lewis. Skip it back over to Miller. Back to Lewis. Miller will reset it with 12 on the shot clock. Miller open three. Left wing is good. That puts CBU on the scoreboard, and it's a 5-3 Charger lead. Nearly 2 minutes gone into this opening half. Chambers, bounce pass, is tipped around and stolen away by Miller. That is our second turnover of this game. Lewis rolls it down underneath, back to the bucket, driving it into the paint, and stolen away, though, by Seth Suave on the backside. Seth brings it back. His layup rims out, no good, and rebounded by CBU.
Well, Steve, UAA's not having any problems getting to the basket. The pace is good offensively.
Just can't finish right now. Lewis directing traffic, dribbles out in front of the Charger bench. Near corner, Rusaltz with it. Fires it up top of the key to Lewis. Back to Miller. Rusaltz for a three ball, and it's no good. Rebounded by J.J. Kaplan. J.J. runs with a head to Seth. Suave with it. Seth gets a high pick, resets it. Chambers open three. Rims out and rebounded by Jackson. CBU slows the tempo down in what is a two-point Charger lead. A little over 3 minutes gone into this opening half. Ball went right through Rusalt's hands and out of bounds to UAH. Nice crowd has filed in here on a Saturday afternoon. And Suave brings it up. Seth sends it over to Chambers underneath to Kaplan. Powers his way up, lays it up and in, does J.J. Maybe that'll trigger J.J. Came in averaging 10.8 per game. Miller crosses the timeline, skips it back over to Rusaltz. Back to Miller, near corner. Driving it, Lewis, his floater from 5 feet, no good. Tipped around, and Malik ends up with the basketball for UAH. Malik drives it. Malik loses the handle, and it's snared away by Jackson defensively by CBU. 7-3-year score, UAH with the lead. Miller for a three, long distance, doinks off the front of the rim, tipped around, and Malik Cook-Stroop comes away with the basketball. Suave with it. Suave attacks the baseline, resets it out to Kaplan. Malik dribbles it out top of the key, finds Suave. Ball is tipped away and stolen away, nicely done defensively by Jackson. Rusaltz back with it. Stops his dribble and fires it over to Miller. Rusaltz holds it, finds Miller, and rolls it down underneath. Back to the bucket, little floater in the lane. No good that time by Gassett, and rebounded by UAH. Driving it, Suave. Little floater rolls in for Seth Suave. The finger roll layup gives the Chargers a 9-3 lead. Nearly 5 minutes gone into this opening half. Miller holds it, sends it over to Lewis, back to Miller. Down underneath it goes to Jackson, spins it, his floater on the baseline. No good, rebounded by Dalton Barkley. The senior from Madison brings it up, fires it up ahead to Suave. Seth back over to Barkley, roll it underneath to Kaplan. J.J. backs his way in, spins, fouled on his way up. J.J. will be awarded with free throws. After our first media timeout, 14:42 left to go here in this opening half. It's a 9-3 start for the UAH Chargers.
The cows are creating a jingle. They want you to remember to eat more chicken. And they've heard that a jingle is the best way to make people remember. They've asked me to sing it to you. Pretty little chicken on a bun, bun, bun. Happy great white meat in your tum, yum, yum. Eat it now, not a cow. Chow, chow. Of course, the cows left out an ingredient or two in Chick-fil-A's original chicken sandwich, but they had trouble rhyming crucial pickles. Once again, pretty little chicken on a bun, bun, bun. Happy great white meat in your tum, yum, yum. Eat it now, not a cow. Chow, chow. Chick-fil-A, home of the original chicken sandwich.
Chick-fil-A on South Memorial Parkway is a proud sponsor of UAH Charger basketball all season long. The South Memorial Parkway Chick-fil-A says, go Chargers and eat more chicken.
We are 4 of 7 from the floor, but Malik Cook-Stroop is 2 of 2 from the floor to start this game. He leads all scorers with 5. 2 for Seth Suave, 2 for J.J. Kaplan. We are 4 of 7 from the floor to start this game, while Christian Brothers is 1 of 7 from the floor. They are shooting
14% from the floor. This is a team that field goal average is 42%.
Well, Steve, it's a great start defensively for UAH. They are flying to the ball. They are moving to the defender, closing the gaps. Coach Shulman telling that in the huddle. The one thing he wants them to do, though, on misses, he wants the ball to get to the point guard's hands a little bit faster on the breaks.
First free throw is good for Kaplan. Second free throw is no good, but then rebounded by UAH, a stoppage in play because the shot clock did not start. 18 on the shot clock as Suave brings it up. It's a 10-3 lead for UAH, lead here early. Lane moves it left wing to Suave, rolls it underneath to J.J. Kaplan. J.J. into the paint, powers his way up. Floater's good for J.J. Kaplan. That is a good sign to see J.J. in rhythm early. It's a 9-point Charger lead at 12-3. Watkins stops his dribble a little bit in no man's land. Now he gets it back. A little 1-3-1 action here defensively. Ball goes tipped underneath and powering his way up. Layup is no good and rebounded by Max Shulman. Malik back with it. Malik skips it outside to Max Shulman. Shulman rolls this into our offense. Lane at the elbow. Kearney hands it over. Malik open three. You bet! Malik Cook-Stroop is now 3-for-3 from the floor. And it's a 12-point Charger lead with nearly 7 minutes gone into this opening half. Miller has it at midcourt, and a 10-second backcourt violation by Miller turns the basketball back over to UAH.
Well, Steve, coming out of that timeout, UAH made just a little bit of a switch for one possession. And that was take away the pressure. But then as soon as they came back down the next trip, the plan was to bring that pressure back. And that pressure has kind of bothered Christian Brothers.
Off the inbounds. A down low to Kearney Lane. His pump fake layup, no good. Kick it out to DA for three. No good. Ball tipped around, and it goes back over to Henley Edge. DA directing traffic. Another look here for UAH. Lane at the elbow, back to Henley, open three. It is good for Henley Edge. How about this start? It is 18-3 UAH, a 30-second timeout taken by the Buccaneers.
You've got to experience Toyota-thon at Bill Penny Toyota. They've got the selection with over 700 new Toyotas to choose from. And they've got the extras with Bill Penny perks and a 10-year unlimited warranty. So get on over to Bill Penny Toyota today and experience Toyota-thon. Bill Penny Toyota in Huntsville and online at BillPennyToyota.com. Bill Penny's Toyota 10-year unlimited warranty is valid through the 10th year of ownership. Valid on new vehicles only. See dealer for details.
97.7 The Zone.
Exactly 7 minutes gone into this opening half. Christian Brothers is 1 of 8 from the floor. And the Chargers lead it by 15. It is 18-3. At least we are showing some full court pressure, but Miller brings it up with Edge on his hip. Sends it over to Watkins along the near sideline. Ball tipped around and out of bounds off of David Anderson. One of the officials was right in the middle of the play as well. Jones to plug it in for CBU. Miller out at midcourt. Holds it. Miller skips it into the near corner to Rusaltz. Back top of the key, it goes to Jones. Rusaltz drives it with 8 on the shot clock. Corner three for Jones is no good. Ball is saved in play. Layup opportunity is kicked around, but a 30-second shot clock violation is the call, and that turns it back over to UAH. How about this defense?
Well, Steve, right now they are doing everything that Coach Shulman would like them to do. I mean, they're moving to the ball. They're flying to the shooters. They're closing the gaps. They're sealing the lane. Christian Brothers really not having too many options offensively.
Anderson brings it up, sends it near corner to Chambers. He'll drive it, skip it over. Henley Edge for three. It is good for Henley Edge. I like this five on the floor right here with Lane, Anderson, Edge, Chambers, and Shulman. Just something about them.
as the ball was kicked off the left Nike of Shulman at midcourt. So it'll say CBU basketball with 23 on the shot clock.
Well, Edge getting a little more playing time today with Sam Orff not in uniform, so making the most of those minutes.
Inbounds it goes. Miller skips it around. Bounce pass to the free throw line there to Jackson. Back to Miller. Miller underneath to Jackson. Layup went under the side of the backboard. Rebounded by J.J. Kaplan on his backside. Ahead it goes to Henley Edge. D.A. open three. Rims out. Rebound above by Kaplan. His floater is partially blocked. Maintains the handle. Edge three. No good. Rebounded by Max Shulman. 20 on the shot clock. Holding it, Shulman sends it over to Tristan Chambers. TC finds Kaplan top of the key. Looks back door. Finds Edge for a three ball. No good. And rebounded by CBU. It's a 21-3 lead for UAH. Rusaltz is bumped by David Anderson. That is our second foul. And with 11:13 to go in this opening half, our second media timeout here is the Chargers in control right now with an 18-point lead.
The cows are creating a jingle. They want you to remember to eat more chicken. And they've heard that a jingle is the best way to make people remember. They've asked me to sing it to you. Pretty little chicken on a bun, bun, bun. Happy great white meat in your tum, yum, yum. Eat it now, not a cow. Chow, chow. Of course, the cows left out an ingredient or two in Chick-fil-A's original chicken sandwich, but they had trouble rhyming crucial pickles. Once again, pretty little chicken on a bun, bun, bun. Happy great white meat in your tum, yum, yum. Eat it now, not a cow. Chow, chow. Chick-fil-A, home of the original chicken sandwich.
Chick-fil-A on South Memorial Parkway is a proud sponsor of UAH Charger basketball all season long. The South Memorial Parkway Chick-fil-A says go Chargers and eat more chicken. 11:13 on the clock. This defensively as good as I've seen UAH all year long.
It has, and Steve, look for them to stay with that pressure at least full court on all makes going forward. Cole Shulman telling the guys we're going to stay with it all makes. The goal here, Steve, they drew it up there. They're going to switch on all screens on the inbounds. He would love to get a five-second call here.
Miller to plug it in, looking. Plugs it in underneath, pivoting around. Jackson layup. No good. Rebounded by Dalton Barkley. Anderson brings it back. D.A. gets a high pick. Sends it over to Shulman. Underneath to J.J. J.J. along the baseline. That's a mismatch. J.J. backs his way into the paint. Pivots. Powers his way up. Lays it up. No good. But he was fouled by Tomic. And that looks like a mismatch from up here in favor of J.J.
Well, it does, and Steve, J.J. got that ball probably about 7 feet, 8 feet from the lane and just kind of worked his way methodically, backing his way down into the lane. And for J.J., that's a good sign. Christian Brothers not overly big with size, and so it's great to see J.J. kind of get that ball down low and have a chance to work.
J.J. misses that first free throw badly. Second free throw for Kaplan. No good, hard off the back of the iron. J.J. now 1 of 3 at the free throw line. Miller brings it up. Miller sends it over to Rusaltz. Back over to Miller, rolls it down underneath. Jackson spins, his layup rolls in. Gassett, actually, not Jackson, my mistake. It's 21-5 now in favor of UAH. Malik drives it. Skips it into the corner. Open three for Max. Is good for Max Shulman. Beautiful ball movement from Malik to Max. And it's now 24-5. Miller bounces it into the backcourt to Rusaltz, who crosses the timeline. Stolen away by David Anderson. Anderson back with it. Drives it. Kicks it. Max for three. No good on the wing. And a loose ball foul on J.J. That'll be his first foul.
Well, Steve, Coach Shulman told us in that Spring Hill game at UAH that it may look like UAH is in a rhythm offensively, but they were being forced the shots. Today, UAH, they're taking the shots they want. They're getting good looks all around.
Ball ends up in Miller's hands, who sends it down low to the baseline. Spinning, powering his way up. Layup is good for Jackson. It's 24-7 now, UAH with the lead in the basketball. 9:38 left to go before halftime. Ball released down low to Kaplan. JJ kick it out. DA open three. It is good for David Anderson. And that is our fifth made three of this opening half, and the lead grows to 20 now at 27-7. Bounce pass goes into the lane. Ball ping-pongs around and out of bounds to CBU. Tristan Chambers, Sessoive are in. David Anderson and J.J. Kaplan are out. Kearney Lane is in. Shulman is out. 18 on the shot clock. Inbounds it goes to Lewis. Miller, three ball. Good. Wow. That was good defense by Dalton Barkley, and Miller just sinks it. Lead shrinks to 17 at 27-10. Holding it at the elbow, Kearney Lane. Hands it over to Malik. Malik drives it, powers his way up. Layup rolls, no good. That's his first miss from the floor. Rebounded by CBU. Quickly back with it is Lewis. His layup no good. A bit out of control and rebounded by TC. Chambers sends it over to Seth for an open three. No good. Ball volleyballed out of play. No saved in play by Rusaltz. And CBU will slow the tempo down. And what is a 27-10 Charger lead? Rusaltz stops his dribble. Sends it over to Lewis. Move it around the arc to Miller. Skip it over to Rusaltz. Pump fakes the three back to Miller. Another three. Misses this one. And over the back violation on Jackson. Climbing all over DB's back. That is team foul number three for CBU. 8:06 left to go before halftime. A 17-point Charger advantage. Largest lead has been 20 when it was 27-7. Lane at the right elbow drives it, attacks it. His layup is blocked right back to him. Kick it outside, TC, open three, no good. Rebounded by CBU. Watkins back with it. Up to Miller, open three, no good on the right wing, and rebounded by UAH. Both teams have hit a dry spell right here offensively. Suave rolls us into our motion offense. Ending up with it, Kearney sends it down low to Malik, who lays it up and in. A timeout taken by Coach Riley. It is a 19-point lead now for UAH at 29-10. It will be the media timeout here with 7:24 to play.
This is Wes Neighbors talking to Chris Haygood of Bob Wallace Appliance. Chris, what sets you apart from other appliance dealerships?
Wes, these appliances are going into the most used room in your house, your kitchen. The way we have these appliances displayed, it's easy for you to visualize how they'll look in your home. Wes, what sets us apart is the people. They're well-trained. In fact, they live and breathe these appliances. And if you need service, you'll really appreciate our parts department.
Contact Bob Wallace Appliance at 256-533-2121.
Tom Luganbill here for Woody Anderson Ford. When I was in the Tennessee Valley, one of the things that impressed me the most was the quality of the people. People like Bobby White and his team at Woody Anderson Ford. And now you can experience the tremendous new service lanes and showroom at Woody Anderson Ford, at Jordan and Sparkman, or just stop by for breakfast or lunch at Henry's Mustang Cafe. And in Madison, visit Woody Anderson of Madison on Hughes Road, just south of 72. Like a great college football tradition, always there. Woody Anderson Ford.
97.7, The Zone.
29-10, your score in favor of UAH. Plenty of former Chargers come to basketball games, and I'm taking a look around up here. Scott Tyson, I see Jamie Gardner off to my left. Right next to Jamie Gardner is Gerard Powers.
Wow.
In the house here.
Wow.
former Decatur Red Raider and former Auburn Tiger, and played how many years in the NFL? Man, good to have him here at the stable here tonight.
Yeah, I believe he played in the Super Bowl as well with the Colts.
Sure did. Miller sends it down underneath. Jamming it down is Haynes. Good ball movement there for CBU. Malik sends it over right wing to J.J. Kaplan. Holding it, Suave finds Chambers. TC resets it. Chambers, open three. It is good for Tristan Chambers. TC came in averaging 14 a game. It's now back up to a 20-point lead at 32-12. Bounce pass tipped and stolen away by Chambers. Chambers quickly back with it. Open three, TC. You bet. Tristan Chambers. It is 35-12 inside the stable. Wow. 6:29 to play. Timeout taken by CBU.
If you bought your life insurance from someone employed by an insurance company, chances are you're paying too much. Individual agents tend to work for a single carrier, meaning you'll only see prices from that one company when better, more affordable options for you may be out there. At Neighbors Insurance, we are brokers who can shop dozens of the top companies for you, so you know you're getting the very best products at the very best prices. Give us a call at 256-469-2324. That's Neighbors Insurance, 256-469-2324, or online at westneighbors.com.
97.7 The Zone.
Other scores from around the Gulf South Conference here this afternoon. It is Montevallo leading it over Auburn Montgomery. 27-13 your score there. Mississippi College, they lead it over Shorter, 16-11. That is in the first half. Delta State with a pretty sizable lead over West Georgia at home, 24-9. And right now it is West Al with a lead over Valdosta State, 22-16. That is in Livingston. Here it is a 35-12 lead, a 23-point lead for the UAH Chargers. Watkins to bring it up. Sends it over to Miller, back over to Watkins. Watkins drives it, stops at the elbow, and the ball is off of Max Schulman's hands. Then it goes right over to Ryan McDaniel. Ryan's not eligible to play in this game.
Well, everyone giving Max a hard time because he came towards Ryan McDaniel, and they were just like, can't you see? I mean, they were just kind of laughing at him.
Inbounds it goes, and it's tipped and out of bounds off of Tristan Chambers.
Well, Steve, honestly, I don't think Christian Brothers is ready for the speed and the drive that UAH is playing with the full court press right now. I think that has been the big key today. Christian Brothers not ready for it.
Watkins out at midcourt, drives it, nearly walks with it. Ball ends up on the deck, and a timeout is granted as J.J. Kaplan ended up on the deck. And a quick 30-second timeout here. The Chargers will have possession of this basketball right after this short order.
Hi, this is Wes Neighbors for Precision Overhead Garage Door Service. Precision Door of Huntsville is a 5-star Google-rated business and a locally owned company that is operating right here in North Alabama. At Precision Door, their slogan is, "We fix garage doors right." Precision Door of Huntsville is a full-service door company specializing in garage doors and other specialty doors, along with replacement of garage doors and repair of garage door openers. Precision Garage Door of Huntsville also offers some same-day service if you call before 2 o'clock. Let them come fix your door. Check out Precision Door of Huntsville online at precisiondoorhuntsville.com. Be sure and ask about their lifetime warranty packages. Tell them West Neighbor sent you.
97.7 The Zone.
Back to action here. Chargers with a 23-point lead and possession of the basketball. Chambers out at midcourt, sends it over to Schulman. A long three for TC, rims out, and a loose ball foul on Kearney Lane will give possession to CBU. That was Majette range right there for that three from Tristan Chambers.
Well, so far, Coach Schulman happy with the shot selection that everybody's taken, so I don't think he minded that one too much.
Well, you're up by 23. Watkins skips it across the timeline. Rusalt into a double team, pivots around, finds Watkins. Ball is tipped out of bounds. Nice catch by a fan, a young fan, in the front row down there. Good hands. CBU basketball with 14 on the shot clock. Watkins looking. Inbounds it to Miller. Miller stepped back, thought about a three. Kicks it back outside with 8 on the shot clock. Miller for a three. Rims out. Long rebound. Stays in CBU's possession. Pump faking the three. Tomic. Back to Rusalt, who drives it. Back to the free throw line and kicks it back out beyond the arc. 8 on the shot clock. Miller resets it. Three ball, actually driving it. Ball is stolen away by J.J. Kaplan. Bringing it back is UAH, leading it 35-12. Backdoor pass goes to Kaplan. Underneath their lane, kick it out. Open three for Max. Rims out, no good. Rebounded by CBU. 4:40 left to go before halftime. It is 35-12 UAH. Miller skips it to Watkins, bounces it left wing to Rusalt. Back over to Miller, right in front of the Charger bench. Watkins, open three, rims out, ends up saved in play by Max Schulman. Running with it is Suave. Seth drives it. Seth finds a knifing J.J. Kaplan, who ends up on the deck as Haynes was trying to take the basketball away and ended up taking J.J.'s right shoulder with him. Team foul number 4 for CBU with 4:14 to play. We actually have people to wipe up the floor.
Well, yes and no. It's the bench having to do it.
Inbounds it goes. Malik Cook-Stroop, who has 10 in this first half, sends it over to Schulman. His release pass is stolen away, though, by Jackson. Running it back, Miller. Miller moves it around the arc. Bounce pass into the near corner to Tomic and rolls it down underneath, and a foul on J.J. That'll be his second foul. And our final media timeout of this opening half. The lead is 23 for UAH at 35-12 here this Saturday afternoon.
In today's fast-paced real estate market, information is everything. Former Charger and local agent David Ivey offers a fresh, innovative approach that he combines with unrivaled technology and amazing personal service. If you are thinking about buying or selling in the Huntsville area, contact David Ivey at IveyHSV.com. That's IveyHSV.com.
Hey, this is Bob Baumhauer here to let you know that something's cooking. Many of y'all know me as that crazy jock that brought buffalo-style chicken wings to Alabama way back when. Turns out we were way ahead of the curve and things changed. Now I'm here to tell you that you're in for another surprise. As a guy who played for Coach Bryant and Don Shula, you got to know it's going to be a winner. Stay tuned and visit us at Baumhauers.com or become a fan on Facebook. You never know who's going to get some free tickets.
97-7 The Zone.
Scores from around the Southeastern Conference. Georgia picks up a big win on the road at ninth-ranked Memphis as the Dogs improved to 10-3 on the year, beating the Memphis Tigers 65-62. And at halftime, it is Auburn leading at Mississippi State at the hump 29-24. Here, it's a 23-point UAH lead. CBU with possession as we're back to action. Jackson elbow jumper rims out, no good. Rebounded by Kearney Lane. Both teams have not scored in over 3 minutes. Knifing in is Kearney, who lays it up and in, does Kearney Lane. And the lead grows to 25 now for UAH at 37-12. Miller bounces. It's stolen away by Malik. Malik back with it. Malik into the lane. Malik kicks it to DA in the corner. Reset it to Schulman, who drives it. Kick it back outside to David Anderson. We roll into our offense with a 25-point cushion. Kearney at the elbow.
Kicks it over to Shulman. Shulman bounces it to Kearney. Pivots around, backs his way in, kick it out to DA for a three. No good. Tipped around, and it will be CBU basketball. Rusaltz back with it. Holds it at midcourt, sends it over right wing to Lewis. Bounce it down underneath. Tomich kicks it back outside from beyond the arc. 15 on the shot clock. Rusaltz with 10 on the shot clock. Drives it into the elbow, kicks it out, and threw it out to midcourt. And just barely saving it was Lewis, who bounces it over. Tomich drives it. His floater no good, but a foul with one on the shot clock. Or was it a shot clock violation?
I think they're going to call an offensive foul.
An offensive charge is the call on Tomich.
Yeah, the offensive charge happened right as the shot clock possession was coming to an end.
DA to bring it up. It's 37-12 UAH. Lane pivots. Kick it out to DA. Ending up with it is Shulman. Max hesitates, drives it, and is fouled that time by Lewis. That is his sixth, that's the team's sixth foul. 2:03 to play before halftime.
Well, Steve, the one thing with UAH only making a basket in the last couple minutes, it's prevented them from getting into their full court trap and getting the pressure and speeding the game up. The game's kind of slowed down a little bit over the last 3 or 4 minutes.
It really has. Kearney finds Malik. His pass is tipped, and I thought that was off CBU. They are conferring, and it is UAH basketball. So the referees get it right there. They did reset the shot clock to 30, and now they'll reset it back to 11. Shulman rolls it underneath the Barkley. Dalton kicks it into the corner. Malik will drive it. Malik will scoop it. He'll lay it up and in. Malik cooks through. He now has 12 first-half points. Believe it or not, he is the only Charger in double figures. 39-12 UAH. Enjoying a 27-point lead over the Bucks. Lewis drives it, powers his way up, and lays it up and in. Darrell Lewis's first made bucket as David Anderson brings it up. Minute 18 left to go before halftime. Malik drives it again, lays it up and in. He was fouled too. They just didn't choose to blow the whistle right there. 41-14. 1 minute left to go before halftime. Miller sends it over. Bounce pass. Stolen away by Malik. Malik brings it back. Malik drives it. Malik fouled by Miller. He will head to the free throw line. Malik Cook-Stroop is 6 of 7 from the floor, 2 of 2 from beyond the arc, and this will be his first free throw attempts of the half. He is an 85% free throw shooter. Front end of the 1-1 is no good. Rebounded by CBU. We're at 45 seconds left to go before halftime. Lewis drives it, mishandles it, and scoops it back up. Kicks it back outside the arc. Miller on the left wing. Back to Rusaltz, who drives it. His pass ends up out of bounds off of Kearney Lane with 11 on the shot clock. A lot of after-whistle bumps right there from CBU. Inbounds it goes. Rusalt's free throw line jumper rims out. No good. Rebounded by UAH. Shot clock turned off. A 27-point lead. Got a chance to add to it. Holding it, Barkley finds Anderson. 10 seconds to go. DA with 8 seconds. Anderson finds Malik on the wing. He'll drive it back over to Anderson. Near corner to Shulman at the buzzer. No good. And the Chargers will have to, I guess, have a 27-point lead heading into halftime. Couldn't make that last jumper. They're going to have to work on that at halftime. 41-14 your score in favor of UAH. holding a team that averages 42% from the floor to 26% from the floor.
Well, Coach, offensively in the first half, you're getting all the shots that you guys want, but defensively, you hold a team to a half to 14 points.
Well, it's been about time for this to happen. We've done a really good job on Miller. The only two times he's made threes is on our screw-ups. So, like Nick Saban would do, I'm going to be mad at the screw-ups. Not happy with the 14 points. I'm mad with the 6 points that we gave him. Offensively, we've really moved that ball, sharing the ball, moving the ball. Everybody's playing their role, which I like. As long as we're taking good shots, I don't care how many threes. I told TC, he just needs to be Klay Thompson. Let's get as many threes up as he can on as few dribbles as we can. So everybody's doing what they're supposed to do. JJ's starting to look like JJ again. It's a good half of basketball.
Now comes the hard part, though. You got to put another 20 together.
Yeah, well, it's kind of like a shooting drill we did this morning. You know, the first 5 minutes, are we going to be satisfied with what we've done, or can we go stomp them right in the daggum throat right off the bat and let's win every four-minute game, and then we'll be in great shape.
All right, Coach. Thanks, Coach. All right, Steve. They're going to reset 20 on the clock. Chargers got to do it all over again.
Well, they'll be up by 27, though. That's the only difference. 41-14 is your score here at halftime. We'll roll through some scores from around the Gulf South Conference, as well as around the Gulf South, as well as SEC basketball, right after these words.
If you bought your life insurance from someone employed by an insurance company, chances are you're paying too much. Individual agents tend to work for a single carrier, meaning you'll only see prices from that one company when better, more affordable options for you may be out there. At Neighbors Insurance, we are brokers who can shop dozens of the top companies for you, so you know you're getting the very best products at the very best prices. Give us a call at 256-469-2324. That's Neighbors Insurance, 256-469-2324, or online at westneighbors.com.
This is Wes Neighbors talking to Chris Haygood of Bob Wallace Appliance. Chris, what sets you apart from other appliance dealerships?
Wes, these appliances are going into the most used room in your house, your kitchen. The way we have these appliances displayed, it's easy for you to visualize how they'll look in your home. Wes, what sets us apart is the people. They're well-trained. In fact, they live and breathe these appliances. And if you need service, you'll really appreciate our parts department.
Contact Bob Wallace Appliance at 256-533-2121.
This is an Alabama legacy moment.
At 2 p.m. on February 16, 1968, the very first 911 call was made in Haleyville, Alabama. The call was made by State Representative Rankin Fite from Haleyville Mayor James Witt's office and was answered by U.S. Representative Tom Bevel at the Haleyville Police Station on a bright red telephone that was given to the city by the Alabama Telephone Company. Haleyville still celebrates their part in 911 history with an annual festival.
Sponsored by the Alabama Bicentennial Commission, the ABA, and this station.
This is an Alabama legacy moment.
When the Soviet Union successfully launched Sputnik in October 1957, the United States needed to quickly join the space race. Werner von Braun, head of the U.S. space program at Redstone Arsenal in Huntsville, suggested using a modified Redstone rocket to President Eisenhower. The resulting rocket, Juno, launched Explorer 1, America's first satellite into orbit, on January 31, 1958. The satellite remained in space until 1970.
Sponsored by the Alabama Bicentennial Commission, the ABA, and this station.
You've got a family that relies on your income to survive, so you know you need life insurance. Do you know what kind to get? Have you told yourself it's too expensive, too complicated, or too much of a hassle? Let your friends at Neighbors Insurance help. We walk you through our simplified, expedited process and shop your business to the top companies out there, finding you better coverage at a lower price. Give us a call at 256-469-2324. That's Neighbors Insurance, 256-469-2324, or online at westneighbors.com.
Attention pet owners. If you're like me, or a lot of us here at 97.7 The Zone, you are a pet owner. This is Steve Moulton for the Greater Huntsville Humane Society and would like to ask you for your help. The Greater Huntsville Humane Society is asking for our help for their Good Samaritan Fund. These are animals that need surgeries for people that cannot afford these surgeries for their dogs, for their cats. I've adopted from the Greater Huntsville Humane Society myself. I have a four-year-old cat named Trick and a six-month-old puppy named Kirby. There are many ways you can donate to the Greater Huntsville Humane Society. You can log on to their website, which is ghhs.org. Or you could simply go by their offices, which is located at 2812 Johnson Road in Huntsville. But I will warn you, you may leave with another member of the family. I speak from personal experience. Kirby urges you to donate today.
Back here at halftime, where the Chargers lead at 41-14. UAH led 19 minutes and 10 seconds of that opening half, and we end up shooting 48% from the floor. We came in averaging 44% from the floor. Beyond the arc, we were 8 of 19. That is good for 42%. That's a little above our average, as we came in averaging 35% beyond the arc as well. Free throws, we came in as a 72% free throw shooting team, and we are 1 of 5 from the free throw line in that first half. J.J. Kaplan was 1 of 4. Malik Cook-Stroop was 0 of 1 in that first half. Turnover-wise, we had 5 turnovers to 16 made buckets, and of those 16 made buckets, 10 assists. It looked awfully good. Christian Brothers shot at 6 of 23 for 26% from the floor. Rebound-wise, UAH out-rebound CBU 22-15. Leading the way for CBU in the first half is Miller with 6. There is only one Charger in double figures, and that is Malik Cook-Stroop, who has 14. 5 for Kaplan, 6 for Chambers, 6 for Henley Edge, 3 apiece for D.A., David Anderson, Max Schulman, and 2 apiece for Seth Suave and Kearney Lane. Not too shabby. Even some point paints for the UAH Chargers as we outscore CBU 16-8 in the paint. Overall, the other games going on in the Gulf South Conference, a lot of really close games. At halftime in Livingston, it's Valdosta State with a 2-point lead at West Alabama. 32-30, your score there. Lee and Union is coming down to cases with a minute 27 to go in that game. Lee leads it 64-62. Late at Lee. The only undefeated team left in GSC play is Montevallo. They lead it over Auburn Montgomery as they are getting ready to start second half action. 41-25, your score there. Mississippi College with an 8-point advantage at home over Shorter, 35-27. And West Georgia is climbing back into this one, but they still trail at the Delta State. Down on the Delta there in Cleveland, Mississippi, 35-22, your score there. We'll have scores from around the SEC next.
Do you plan on retiring one day? Are you worried about market losses and how they may affect your future? Did you know it only takes 2 consecutive years of market losses to completely derail a retirement plan? What if there were a way to get a decent return with minimal risk? At Neighbors Wealth Management, we'll show you how this is possible and what you can do to make sure your retirement stays on track. Give us a call, 256-469-2324. That's Neighbors Wealth Management, 256-469-2324, or online at neighborswealthmanagement.com. These days, many folks retire not knowing exactly how taxes work on Social Security and retirement accounts. They find out way too late in the game, needlessly losing money to taxes they could have easily avoided with just a little bit of expert guidance. At Neighbors Wealth Management, we can show you easy steps that you can take to reduce taxes in your retirement. Give us a call at 256-469-2324. That's Neighbors Wealth Management, 256-469-2324, or online at neighborswealthmanagement.com.
97.7 The Zone.
Off we go to some SEC basketball, as quite a few games tipping it up today in SEC play. LSU gets a road win at Tennessee. 78-64 is that final score. Other finals, Kentucky is a winner over Mizzou, 71-59, as the Kentucky Wildcats are now 10-3 on the year. Georgia gets a non-conference road win at Memphis, beating the Memphis Tigers, 65-62. Auburn leads it at Mississippi State with 15 minutes left to go in that game, 38-31. There at the hump. It's close late with under 5 minutes left to go in Lawrence, Kansas, as the third-ranked Jayhawks are in a bit of a tussle with West Virginia. 74-72, Jayhawks with the lead. I'll keep a close eye on that one. Wichita State is having their way with Ole Miss right now. 7 minutes left to go in that game. It's the Shockers 64, the Ole Miss Rebels 48. And a few other finals. Florida State a winner at Louisville, 78-65. That's a little bit of a surprise. 10th-ranked Villanova loses on the road at Marquette, 71-60. Your score there. And Penn State gets a 3-point home win over Iowa, 89-86. Your score there. Other games that'll tip it up later include Vanderbilt playing host to SMU. Number one Gonzaga is home to Pepperdine. And Lipscomb is on the road tonight at Florida Gulf Coast as the Bison coming off of a 3-point road win at Stetson earlier in the week on Thursday. Final timeout here as we get ready for second half action. It is all UAH here inside the stable. A 27-point lead for the UAH Chargers.
In today's fast-paced real estate market, information is everything. Former Charger and local agent David Ivey offers a fresh, innovative approach that he combines with unrivaled technology and amazing personal service. If you are thinking about buying or selling in the Huntsville area, contact David Ivey at IveyHSV.com. That's IveyHSV.com.
Hey, this is Bob Baumhauer here to let you know that something's cooking. Many of y'all know me as that crazy jock that brought buffalo-style chicken wings to Alabama way back when. Turns out we were way ahead of the curve and things changed. Now I'm here to tell you that you're in for another surprise. As a guy who played for Coach Bryant and Don Shula, you got to know it's going to be a winner. Stay tuned and visit us at Baumhauers.com or become a fan on Facebook. You never know who's going to get some free tickets.
97.7 The Zone.
Along with Scott Tyson, Steve Moulton back here with you. Hey, you got your table back over there.
Well, just for a minute. Just for a minute. But just out of that locker room, and, you know, Coach Shulman very happy with the performance in the first half. He liked the fact that they were ready to roll defensively. He said it wasn't a perfect first half defensively because he felt, and I mean, now we're getting down to the nitty-gritty, though.
Yeah.
But he felt like they should have just been held to 6 points. Yeah. He did tell the guys, though, look, when you get to that court now, you're going to be fighting human nature because you have a 41-14 lead. He goes, they're going to come out. They're going to throw a punch. He goes, but how about we throw the first one? Let's try to go on a 5-0, 6-0 run in the first 4 minutes. And he goes, let's really work on some things. Look to see and possibly UAH to play some zone defense here in the second half. Just to simply see if they can handle playing zone defense and guarding someone out of the zone. Work on a few things down the road. They do want to get the ball to the point guard a little bit faster coming on the breaks. They don't want Malik Cookstroop. They don't want a lot of other guys bringing that ball up. That's Seth Swab's job. They want to get it into his hands a lot faster and to get that offense going. Other than that, though, Steve, I mean, it was a pretty easy going halftime speech.
Well, that fighting human nature thing, I've called way too many of these games between CBU and UAH
not to think that CBU is going to give us their best punch here in the first 5 minutes of this second half. We will put onto the court Kearney Lane, Max Schulman, Seth Suave, J.J. Kaplan, and Malik Cook-Stroop. It will be Charger basketball. 20 more minutes up on the clock. Here we go with the second half. Can we keep the gas pedal matched? Kaplan, right wing, finds Lane, top of the key. Schulman underneath and a foul underneath on the backside by Lewis. That'll be his second foul. 21 on the shot clock. Schulman to plug it in, looking, plugs it into Kaplan. Move it around the arc, ends up in Schulman's hands, underneath to Kaplan. J.J. into the lane, floater in the lane, rolls in for J.J. He now has 7 in the game. It is 43-14, a 29-point lead for the Chargers. Lewis drives it in. His layup is no good, but a blocking foul on UIH on Kearney Lane. That'll be Kearney's second foul.
Well, Steve, if you look at the charts, the stat chart from the first half, this is something that we didn't see in the first half, and that is free throws from Christian Brothers.
Yeah, this is their first free throw attempt of the game. Lewis, free throw. Good. As a team, CBU is a 66% free throw shooting team. Second free throw. Good. 43-16 now. Chargers with the lead in the basketball as the lead remains 27. Schulman down underneath to Kaplan. J.J. attacks the baseline. His layup rolls in for J.J. Kaplan. He now has 9 in the game. Lead grows back to 29. Miller holds it. Skips it up top of the key. Tomich with it. Holds it at the elbow, dribbled it off his foot, and sends it back outside for a three ball, and it's no good by Miller. Quickly up with it is Suave. Seth drives it. Seth scoops it. Seth misses the layup and rebounded by CBU. Little over a minute gone here into the second half. It is 45-16 UAH. Holding it, Jackson sends it over to Miller right in front of his own bench. Miller skips it over to Tomich, down low to Jackson, pivots, off the glass and good. Good move there by Joshua Jackson. His second made bucket, and it's 45-18 now. We roll into our motion offense. Nearly 2 minutes gone, backdoor passes there. J.J. lays it up and in. Good look from Suave to Kaplan, and it's 47-18. We are making a concerted effort to get it into J.J.'s hands to start this second half, and it is paying off. Move it around the arc. We're in his zone defense. Tomich skips it outside to Lewis for a three ball. It's no good. Rebounded by Kearney Lane. Suave quickly up with it. Suave bounces it to Max. Move it over to Kaplan. Down underneath to Kearney. Powers his way up. Floater rattles in for Kearney Lane. His second made bucket. 49-18.
Yeah, the second half, UAH starting with the intent of just pounding it down low.
Yeah, three ball is no good on the top of the key for Rusaltz, and let's slow the tempo down at least a little bit. Max, his pass is out of bounds. Nice defensive effort that time by Lewis, by CBU. 17:15 on the clock left to go. Here inside the stable, this is our final home game until January the 23rd when we play host to Delta State. Bringing it up, says Suave, finds Schulman, rolls it underneath to J.J. J.J. backs his way in the paint. J.J. pivots, floater in the lane, no good, off the front of the rim. 3 minutes gone into the second half. Holding it, Lewis moves it around the arc. Miller back to Lewis, drives it, scoops it, lays it up, no good. Tipped around and running with it is Malik. Malik drives it. Malik, an offensive foul. No, they're going to call a defensive block. Did you see what I saw?
Well, the defender was shifting a little bit to the left. He wasn't completely set, and Malik was on the attack.
I saw the elbow fly. Inbounds it goes. Kaplan holds it. Move it over to Seth Suave. His pass is ricocheted right back to him. Seth drives it. Needs help. Finds it. Malik, open three. Rims out. No good. Rebounded by CBU. We have made eight threes in this game. Miller tries to make a three, and it rims out, went halfway down. So far, that is the story of this game for CBU. Suave, near corner, goes to Malik. 49-18, Chargers with the lead and the basketball. Malik over to Kearney Lane. Stops at the elbow, kick it out to Suave, open three. No good, and rebounded by CBU. Tomich back with it, sends it up ahead to Lewis. He'll reset it. Both teams kind of just feel like they're just in the motion of their offense, but not really feeling the game, if you know what I mean. Lewis stops his dribbling, moves it back over to Rusaltz. Three on the shot clock. Lewis for three. It's no good. Rebounded by UAH. Suave drives it. Seth will reset it from beyond the arc. Nearly 5 minutes gone into the second half. Pivoting around as Kaplan finds Max along the baseline. 12 on the shot clock. Kearney into the near corner to Suave. Seth drives it. Scoop layup rolls in for Seth Suave. 51-18, your new score now in favor of UAH. 14:44 to play here inside the stable. Miller skips it over right wing. That's to Lewis. Lewis into the free throw line. Jump stop, down low, ball swatted away. Ooh, I thought that was clean by Kearney. Timeout, our first media timeout here of this second half. UAH with a 51-18 lead over Christian Brothers.
This is Wes Neighbors talking to Chris Haygood of Bob Wallace Appliance. Chris, what sets you apart from other appliance dealerships?
Wes, these appliances are going into the most used room in your house, your kitchen. The way we have these appliances displayed, it's easy for you to visualize how they'll look in your home. Wes, what sets us apart is the people. They're well-trained. In fact, they live and breathe these appliances. And if you need service, you'll really appreciate our parts department.
Contact Bob Wallace Appliance at 256-533-2121.
Tom Luganbill here for Woody Anderson Ford. When I was in the Tennessee Valley, one of the things that impressed me the most was the quality of the people. People like Bobby White and his team at Woody Anderson Ford. And now you can experience the tremendous new service lanes and showroom at Woody Anderson Ford, at Jordan and Sparkman, or just stop by for breakfast or lunch at Henry's Mustang Cafe. And in Madison, visit Woody Anderson of Madison on Hughes Road, just south of 72. Like a great college football tradition, always there, Woody Anderson Ford.
97.7, The Zone.
51-18, your score as the UAH Chargers in control here at home. Some other scores to pass along to you. I am going to try to update some scores if I can. Valdosta State with a 39-33 lead at West Alabama. 41-25, Montevallo with the lead over Auburn Montgomery. That is at halftime. And Delta State leads it in the second half over West Georgia, 37-24. Your score there. Front end of the free throws, no good for Gassett, but he drains the second free throw, and it's now 51-19, a 32-point lead for UAH. Tristan Chambers into the game for the Chargers and brings it up. Chambers sends it over to Barkley, left wing to Suave. Seth Back over to Shulman, who drives it into the elbow, draws a double team. Somebody's open. It's JJ. He'll attack the paint, tries to jam it down, and he's fouled on his way down, it looked like. Looked like JJ's okay.
He's grabbing that right elbow just a little bit.
Yep. JJ trying to jam it home. And then turns around and talks to Miller as if to say, why couldn't you help me jam that basketball? Kaplan, who has struggled at the free throw line, continues to do so. He's now 1 of 5 at the free throw line. Second free throw is good for JJ. 52-19. It is all UAH. Now ahead by a full Larry Bird, 33. Bounce pass goes into the free throw line. Haynes kicks it outside to Jones. Stops his dribble back to Haynes. He walked with it. Scoop layup rolls in, though. Boy, did he drag that pivot foot. It's like he was on ice skates or something. 52-21. Chambers, his pass is stolen away by Jones. Jones in the other direction. His layup swatted away by Tristan Chambers, but it goes out of bounds off of TC. It will stay Buck basketball with 13:41 to play. Inbounds it goes along the baseline. Taking the charge was JJ, and they will call the foul on Jackson, barreling into JJ.
Kind of a late whistle.
It was.
I think they were just kind of waiting for each other to blow the whistle on the call. But I mean, it's the right call, but it's just a little late.
13:38 to play. We'll look at the schedule ahead. Chargers on the road at Shorter coming up on Thursday. Shulman drives it. His pass ping-pongs around, and it ends up out of bounds off of CBU. 21 on the shot clock, 13:28 on the game clock. Shulman to plug it into play. Max looking, sends it in the corner to Chambers, underneath to Shulman. Pump fake, his floater is no good, rebounded by CBU. Miller back with it. Miller bounces it into the corner to Lewis. He gets doubled back to Miller. We stay in that zone defense. Jackson drives it and then kicks it into the corner to Lewis. Back to Jackson. His floater is good. Jackson's third made bucket. It's 52-23 now. 7 minutes gone into this second half. Underneath. Getting held big time was Tristan Chambers. How was that not an intentional foul? It turned into a bear hug more than anything. Chambers was left open underneath the hoop. I don't know how that's not an intentional foul. Foul occurred on the floor, so no free throws. It was a bear hug. The defender was behind Tristan Chambers. Inbounds it goes to Kaplan with 20 on the shot clock. Chambers open three, rims out. Stick back though is good for Malik, or for Max. Was he out of bounds?
I think we have an offensive. Yeah, I think it was out of bounds. Yeah.
So I guess Max, his right foot must have hit the end line, and Buccaneer ball. Miller sends it over to Watkins, back over to Miller. Watkins skips it in the corner for three for Lewis, and it's good. That is just the third made three for Christian Brothers in this game. 52-26 your score now. Chambers skips it over, and it's tipped out of bounds off of Lewis, and it will be, how is that Christian Brothers basketball? Well, CBU gets the basketball. No argument from either side, so it is CBU ball with 12:02 and counting to play in this game. 52-26, your score now. Holding it, right wing, Watkins. Ending up on the deck, that time is Lewis. That's either a walk or a foul. And it looked like he slid down before there was any foul. They're going to call a jump ball. Possession arrow to CBU. Timeout on the floor, 11:52 to play. It is 52-26 in favor of UAH.
The cows are creating a jingle. They want you to remember to eat more chicken. And they've heard that a jingle is the best way to make people remember. They've asked me to sing it to you. Pretty little chicken on a bun, bun, bun. Happy great white meat in your tum, yum, yum. Eat it now, not a cow. Chow, chow. Of course, the cows left out an ingredient or two in Chick-fil-A's original chicken sandwich, but they had trouble rhyming crucial pickles. Once again, pretty little chicken on a bun, bun, bun. Happy great white meat in your tum, yum, yum. Eat it now, not a cow. Chow, chow. Chick-fil-A, home of the original chicken sandwich.
Chick-fil-A on South Memorial Parkway is a proud sponsor of UAH Charger basketball all season long. The South Memorial Parkway Chick-fil-A says, go Chargers and eat more chicken. Other scores around the Southeastern Conference. Auburn now with a 10-point lead at Mississippi State with under 8 minutes left to go there. 56-46. Alabama with a 2-point lead on the road at Florida, 9-7. Glad to see Chris Stewart back on the call for the Crimson Tide Sports Network as he was in the hospital for quite a while and is back where he belongs along Media Row, putting that headset back on. Inbounds it goes. Watkins moves it up top of the key to Lewis. Down underneath, pivoting and walking with the basketball is Haynes, and that turns it right back over to UAH.
Well, Steve, UAH going back to that man-to-man defense. Coach wants that defensive edge back. Felt like they kind of lost it a little bit there when they went to that zone.
Kearney at the elbow gets bumped on the backside by Lewis. That'll be Lewis's fourth foul. Yes. 52-26. It is all UAH right now. Inbounds it goes. David Anderson to bring it up. Barkley looks back door and it went right through a couple of players' wickets and out of bounds to CBU. Valdosta State is stretching their lead out at Livingston. They now lead it against West Alabama 48-33. Watkins, right wing, sends it up top of the key to Jackson. Miller pump fakes a three. Rusaltz pump fakes a three, drives it, skips it in the corner. Watkins for a three ball, and it's good. That is Watkins' first made bucket of the game. It is 52-29. Backdoor pass is there to Barkley. His layup is good. Count the bucket. Dalton Barkley with an and one opportunity. With just a hair under 11 minutes left to go in this game. What a start to this game as UAH at 1 point led it early 27-7. The and one is no good for Dalton Barkley. But it was really started on the defensive side of the basketball.
Yeah, the pressure when UAH was running that full court traps and the pressure, CBU just really didn't have an answer for, didn't know how to play against it.
Little half court press is broken again there for UAH. To the other end goes Kearney Lane. Layup no good. Ball ends up on the deck and out of bounds to UAH. Last touch by Haynes by CBU.
Well, Steve, really, that's about the first time we've seen UAH really push the tempo here in the second half, getting back to what was working so well in the second half.
Chambers plugs it into play to Barkley. Move it around the arc to Malik Cook-Strew. Ending up with it is Chambers. Bounces it over to Kearney. Malik with 14 in this game. David Anderson tries a three ball and it rims out. No good. Rebounded by Jackson. Halfway done with the second half and it's 54-29. UAH has led all but 10 seconds of this game, and that was the first 10 seconds of the game. Jackson skips it out to Miller. Left wing three ball is no good. Rebounded by UAH. DA ahead to Malik, who attacks the paint, lays it up, and in! Count the bucket! Malik Cook-Stroop now with 16 in the game. That's his first points of the second half. As Shulman is in. Jack Klein is in. Seth Suave is in. Henley Edge will come in if Malik makes this free throw. Free throw. Good. 17 now in the game for Malik.
He's had a great game. You know, he kind of struggled. He's been kind of struggling offensively the last couple games. He's put a lot of extra work in the gym, and it's good to see today having that offensive success.
57-29, a little half-court press now. Rusaltz with it. Starts off the dribble, releases it down low to Jackson. His ball stolen away by Henley Edge. Suave quickly up with it. It's 57-29, and we're not done. Kaplan to Edge, who drives it. Kick into the corner, open three for Suave. Rims out, no good. Rusaltz back with it. For CBU, Miller starts off the dribble and moves it around the arc. Back to Miller. Looking underneath, and Gassett is locked up right now as Miller ends up with the handle out at midcourt. 8 seconds on the shot clock. Miller, a contested three ball. No good. Long rebound, though, goes to Jackson. CBU maintains the handle with 8:40 on the clock. Rusalt bounce passes it underneath to Jackson. Loses the handle, stolen away by Shulman to the other end. Backdoor pass goes to J.J. Kaplan, who's fouled. Are they going to give him free throws? No, they're not. They're going to say it occurred on the floor. Oh, it's a one-and-one opportunity here for J.J.
Yeah, it's the ninth team foul for Christian Brothers. I mean, but see, Steve, though, that was a great example. UAH with the turnover, and they get the ball into the point guard's hands right away.
Front end of the one-and-one is no good. J.J. will no doubt be working on those free throws. Bringing it up, Tomich bounces it to Miller. Tomich drives it, kicks it over left wing. Rusaltz back to Tomich, pump fakes a three, top of the key jumper for two. No good, and rebounded by J.J. Kaplan. Suave back with it. Under 8 minutes left to go in this game now. It is 57-29, UAH in control here on a Saturday afternoon slash evening. Suave bounces it over to Jack Klein. Backdoor pass goes to Kaplan, who was fouled on his way up, and he will get some free throws right after this word from Woody Anderson Ford.
Here's Bobby White from Woody Anderson Ford on their service department.
President's Award winner 2 years in a row. That's only given to the top 10% of Ford dealers in customer satisfaction. So we're very proud of the service department and our body shop. If you happen to get into an accident, which not a lot of people just want to go down and see a body shop, but if you get into an accident, award-winning body shop. We have state-of-the-art paint booths back there. They're waterborne paints that we use, friendly for the environment. We've got our production system, the way things are in and out. We have the fastest cycle rate in town of getting your vehicle in, getting your vehicle out, and assured that it's fixed right. We take pictures before it's wrecked, and not only after, but we take it as we're putting the parts on. All done to above industry standards. So I'm proud of our body shop too. don't forget our parts department. So, you know, if you happen to need parts, performance parts, or just parts if you're a weekend mechanic.
Woody Anderson Ford, located at the corner of Jordan and Sparkman, as well as Hughes Road and Madison. You can also check out the great deals at WoodyAndersonFord.com.
Next Saturday, we are on the road in Cleveland, Tennessee. A very interesting matchup with the Lee Flames. Lee was a winner today over Union, 76-72. I think that will be a very intriguing game next Saturday when we travel to Cleveland, Tennessee.
Yeah, you remember last year, UAH had come off a loss. I think it was to Union, and then we went to Lee. And UAH played probably one of their better ball games, complete ball games last year there in Lee. So it's going to probably take another performance like that going up there next weekend.
JJ makes the front end of his free throws and gets a little bit of the Bronx cheer. Second free throw, no good. Rebounded by Jack Klein. Chargers maintain the handle in what is a 58-29 lead. Suave to Shulman, who drives it. Max pump fakes. His floater partially blocked that time by Lewis. CBU basketball. I like that pump fake right there, though. Miller rolls it down low to Jackson. Kick it outside. Rusalt's a contested three is no good. Rebounded by J.J. Kaplan. 7:15 to go. It is 58-29, UAH with the lead. Led it by as much as 33 in this game. Edge's pass is tipped up into the air and stolen away by Miller. Miller brings it back. Move it around the arc. Lewis rolls it underneath. Little power hook. No good that time by Haynes in the lane and rebounded by UAH. CBU is now 5 of 17 from the floor here in this second half. We are 7 of 17 from the floor here in this second half. Edge rolls it to Klein. Back to Edge for a three ball. Hits hard off the back of the rim. No good. Lewis holds it right wing. Move it around the arc. It'll end up back in Lewis's hands. Now Jackson to Miller, right wing. Lewis, top of the key, three balls, no good. Rebounded by Jack Klein. We take it 6 minutes now left to go. Suave hesitates, bounces it underneath to Kaplan. JJ along the baseline. JJ skips it out to Edge for an open three, and it's no good. As we've kind of gone ice cold here the last few possessions. Three ball is good in the corner there for Lewis. His second made three, and it's 58-32 now. Timeout taken as a few more subs are coming in for UAH. There is a lot of time on this clock. 5:36 to play. I mean, I know we've got a lot of capable guys, but there is a lot of time on this clock. 5:36 to go. It is 58-32. That's what I get to do up here. I get to question judgment because I'm not the head coach.
The cows are creating a jingle. They want you to remember to eat more chicken. And they've heard that a jingle is the best way to make people remember. They've asked me to sing it to you. Pretty little chicken on a bun, bun, bun. Happy great white meat in your tum, yum, yum. Eat it now, not a cow. Chow, chow. Of course, the cows left out an ingredient or two in Chick-fil-A's original chicken sandwich, but they had trouble rhyming crucial pickles. Once again, pretty little chicken on a bun, bun, bun. Happy great white meat in your tum, yum, yum. Eat it now, not a cow. Chow, chow. Chick-fil-A, home of the original chicken sandwich.
Chick-fil-A on South Memorial Parkway is a proud sponsor of UAH Charger basketball all season long. The South Memorial Parkway Chick-fil-A says go Chargers and eat more chicken. Calvin Walker to plug it into play and does so in the backcourt to David Anderson. 58-32, Chargers with the lead in the basketball. Move it around the arc. Harding drives it into the elbow. Back near corner it goes to David Anderson. 12 on the shot clock. Klein at the elbow. Jack out to Calvin for a three ball. It is good for Calvin Walker. Just sitting on the bench, ice cold, and light him up with a three on his very first possession. Rusaltz bounces it top of the key. Lewis skips it over to Miller. Three ball from long distance is good. His third made three of the game. 61-35, Chargers with the lead in the basketball. Klein finds Anderson. Swing it near corner to Edge. Jack along the baseline. Skips it over, but it's stolen away by Miller. Miller brings it back underneath to Jackson. Jackson, his pass, goes to Haynes, who pump fakes and lays it up and in. 61-37. Chargers content to run our motion offense here. Harding to Klein. Hand it over to Anderson. Underneath to Jack, who lays it up and in. Good look from D.A. to Jack Klein. 4:04 and counting left to play. Miller pump fakes, drives it, and is bumped by Calvin Walker. Our final media timeout right here. 3:58 to go. Chargers in control, leading it 63-37.
In today's fast-paced real estate market, information is everything. Former Charger and local agent David Ivey offers a fresh, innovative approach that he combines with unrivaled technology and amazing personal service. If you are thinking about buying or selling in the Huntsville area, contact David Ivey at IveyHSV.com. That's IveyHSV.com.
Hey, this is Bob Baumhauer here to let you know that something's cooking. Many of y'all know me as that crazy jock that brought buffalo-style chicken wings to Alabama way back when. Turns out we were way ahead of the curve and things changed. Now I'm here to tell you that you're in for another surprise. As a guy who played for Coach Bryant and Don Shula, you got to know it's going to be a winner. Stay tuned and visit us at Baumhauers.com or become a fan on Facebook. You never know who's going to get some free tickets.
97.7 The Zone.
Lee is a winner over Union, 76-72. Late second half. West Al is trying to climb back in. It is a 10-point lead for Valdosta State at 57-47. Delta State leads it over West Georgia, 58-53. Here, it's a 63-37 lead for the UAH Chargers. Inbounds, Rusaltz, jumper is good. They're going to count the bucket, say he was bumped on his way up. I really do appreciate the fine folks here at the program for allowing this one-sided affair to occur, because we've got to go over to the VBC tonight for some hockey.
Well, Steve, after the dust settles in this one, you wonder what the statement that UAH will make to the rest of the league. I mean, when you go on the road, you lose to Valdosta and West Florida.
Yep.
People begin to question. Coaches like, you know, we lost our swagger a little bit. We lost the mentality of being the hunter. People were hunting us. We lost that. Now we've got to go get everybody. So you wonder what the message that you this win here, assuming UAH is able to hold on, what they'll be able to send to the rest of the league.
Yeah. I mean, ultimately, you're a 4-2 team in Gulf South Conference play. But the good news is all the teams that are in front of you, you play. Klein misses the front end of the free throws. Second free throw is no good as well. Rebounded by CBU. Rusaltz rolls it underneath. Layup no good. Haynes will head to the free throw line with 3:38 on the clock. It's a 23-point lead right here for UAH. 1 minute left to go in Starkville. Auburn leads it 76-63 over Mississippi State.
Well, that's a big road win right there.
It
for
is.
For Auburn to start SEC play.
Both free throws are good for Haynes. 3:33 and counting left to go here. Edge bounces it to Dilling and rolls it to Jack Klein. Jack sends it near corner to Luke Tomlinson. Klein along the baseline, backs his way in. Jump stop, little layup is swatted right back to him. Kick it outside to Henley Edge. Five on the shot clock. Henley drives it. His floater is good! Henley Edge! Wow! A little off balance, and that was impressive. Stolen away by Calvin Walker. Cal to the other end, lays it up, and no good. Rebounded by Miller. Under 3 minutes left to go in this game. Into the corner to Lewis. Lewis sends it along the baseline. A 3 second lane violation, the call on CBU, and it will be UAH basketball. Bringing it up to Tomlinson. Move it around the arc to Walker. Swing it left wing to Henley Edge. Klein hands it back over to Edge, who drives it, kicks it, and an offensive foul on Henley Edge. Gives the Bucks the basketball right back. There is far more fans in the stands than I would have thought, so kudos to the fans here for sticking around, because they know this is their last home game for a while. Three road games in a row after this one. Backdoor pass is there to Haynes. His layup is good. 65-44 now with 2:05 on the clock. Harding starts off the dribble on the left hand and sends it over to Tomlinson. Far corner it goes to Walker. Cal bounces it to Tomlinson. Sends it down low, but it's stolen away by CBU. Ahead it goes to Lewis. Open three, and the wing is good. 65-47. Minute and a half to go. Walker holds it. Sends it over to Harding. Still 18 on the shot clock. Tomlinson kicks it into the corner to Edge. Drives it. His shot, no good, but he was just about decapitated on his way up.
Well, Steve, the good thing is we do got players that are getting some extended minutes. And you look at the group that we have on the floor, you know, Riley Webster not able to go today as well.
Yep.
But, you know, for the last 5 or 6 minutes, we saw a lot of that group that played early in the season. Those five that came in early in the year during a rotation. So, I mean, these five, you never know when they're going to be countered on.
Front end rims out for Henley. Apparently, Jerry Jeudy has just declared for the NFL draft. Second free throw is good. I think we're all waiting on Monday, though, aren't we?
Yeah, question is, what time on Monday?
I don't know that answer either. I've been asked, and I have no idea. Left elbow jumper is good for Haynes. Didn't realize that I had that much pull with the Alabama football program that I can set the time, because people have been asking me like I know. But I have no idea when that press conference is happening on Monday. Klein bounces it to Harding, kicking to the corner for Edge for three, and it rims out, no good. Tipped out to midcourt, regathered by Klein. 40 seconds to go. Rusaltz with the steal. Drives it, scoops it, lays it up and in, count the bucket. He is fouled on the play.
Well, Steve, the one thing is, I know a lot of people are probably sitting there, well, when is Christian Brothers going to go to their bench and just kind of empty it out? They don't have a lot of guys.
No, they don't.
They only have nine total players dressed. So that bench is awful thin, and it's been awfully thin all game. And, you know, that's a big reason why UAH came out, put a lot of pressure on them early, and they didn't have a lot of depth.
Shot clock and game clock are about 3 seconds apart. Tomlinson with it in the near corner. Luke sends it over to Klein. Move it around the arc to Edge, who drives it. He'll scoop it. He'll lay it up and no good. Rebounded by Miller. Miller fires it up ahead, down low the baseline to Haynes, who pivots. His shot swatted away by Klein. Three ball by Rusaltz is no good, and that'll do it. The UAH Chargers in control for the game and run away with it. 66-52 is your final score over Christian Brothers. Chargers improved to 12-2 on the year, 4-2 in GSC play, while CBU falls to 5-8 and 2-4 in the GSC. We'll head into our postgame after these words from Woody Anderson Ford.
Here's Bobby White from Woody Anderson Ford on their service department.
President's Award winner 2 years in a row. That's only given to the top 10% of Ford dealers in customer satisfaction. So we're very proud of the service department and our body shop. If you happen to get into an accident, which not a lot of people just want to go down and see a body shop, but if you get into an accident, award-winning body shop. We have the state-of-the-art paint booths back there. They're waterborne paints that we use, friendly for the environment. We've got our production system, the way things are in and out. We have the fastest cycle rate in town of getting your vehicle in, getting your vehicle out, and assured that it's fixed right. We take pictures before it's wrecked, and not only after, but we take it as we're putting the parts on. All done to above industry standards. So I'm proud of our body shop too. Don't forget our parts department. So you know, if you happen to need parts, performance parts, or just parts if you're a weekend mechanic.
Woody Anderson Ford, located at the corner of Jordan and Sparkman, as well as Hughes Road in Madison. You can also check out the great deals at WoodyAndersonFord.com.
The cows are creating a jingle. They want you to remember to eat more chicken. And they've heard that a jingle is the best way to make people remember. They've asked me to sing it to you. Pretty little chicken on a bun, bun, bun. Happy great white meat in your tum, yum, yum. Eat it now, not a cow. Chow, chow. Of course, the cows left out an ingredient or two in Chick-fil-A's original chicken sandwich, but they had trouble rhyming crucial pickles. Once again, pretty little chicken on a bun, bun, bun. Happy great white meat in your tum, yum, yum. Eat it now, not a cow. Chow, chow. Chick-fil-A, home of the original chicken sandwich.
Chick-fil-A on South Memorial Parkway is a proud sponsor of UAH Charger basketball all season long. The South Memorial Parkway Chick-fil-A says, go Chargers and eat more chicken.
If you bought your life insurance from someone employed by an insurance company, chances are you're paying too much. Individual agents tend to work for a single carrier, meaning you'll only see prices from that one company when better, more affordable options for you may be out there. At Neighbors Insurance, we are brokers who can shop dozens of the top companies for you, so you know you're getting the very best products at the very best prices. Give us a call at 256-469-2324. That's Neighbors Insurance, 256-469-2324, or online at westneighbors.com.
97.7 The Zone.
Off to the postgame we go as the Chargers are winners 66-52, but a lead of 41-14 at halftime and really never looked back from the very beginning. At one point, starting this game, 27-7 was at one point. We just kind of looked at the score and went, oh my. But the defense really was the story of this game for the UAH Chargers, forcing 21 Christian Brother turnovers that turned into 18 UAH points.
And you knew coming out in the second half, it was going to be tough to duplicate that success that they put together in the first half. I mean, that was going to be tough, but, you know.
They didn't have the same defensive pressure, though.
They didn't need that same defensive pressure, though, either. And
yep.
I mean, I think if they had to come out there and play with that pressure in the second half, I think they would have been fully capable of it, but that is the start that Coach Shulman has wanted to see. And, I mean, on numerous occasions, He's asked for it. He felt like they were ready for it. And, you know, for whatever reason, they'd come out slow and they'd come out sluggish. Tonight, I think, was one of the first nights that we've seen them, I mean, literally put everything together offensively, defensively, for the first 20 minutes of a ball game. And
yeah.
I tell you what, that's awfully hard to do because, I mean, basically what UAH did was Christian Brothers tapped out really midway through that first half. I mean, they couldn't do anything.
No, they couldn't. Some scores from around the Gulf South Conference. There is a couple of finals, but quite a few close games going on. Lee is a winner over Union, 76-72 is that final score. Late second half, Valdosta State is a winner, or actually leading at West Alabama, 66-53. There's still a minute left to go in that game. How about this? Auburn Montgomery has come back. At one point, Montevallo led this game by 18 points. It is now tied at 63 with 12 seconds to play. That is at Montevallo. Late in the second half, it's Mississippi College in control at home over Shorter, 65-52. A tight one on the Delta with 2 minutes left to go. Delta State leads it by 3 over West Georgia, 67-64. But overtime is occurring right now at Montevallo between Auburn Montgomery and Montevallo. They are tied at 63 heading into overtime. Gotta love conference basketball when you flip the calendar over to January and really ramp it up.
Well, Steve, we got Coach Shulman here right now. Coach, congratulations. Great win today. That was a conference win. I mean, that you've wanted a fast start. You got that in the first half. Pretty impressive.
Well, listen, I'm not going. We didn't play very good the last 6 minutes. I'm not going to let that affect the day. We came out with great energy. First media timeout. We had to win the first 4 minutes. We won the first 4 minutes. We're up 30 something. Human nature. We let down. We'll take care of that on film. So proud of our kids coming out with great energy. We were pretty good tonight, and we were pretty good without arguably our best player. Yep. And so we're going to get – what was nice is we have an opportunity to rest Sam today. We don't play till Thursday. He'll have a couple days off again. We're about to get to full speed and with the full team, and then we got a chance to be pretty good.
I know you want to see a full 40-minute game, but was that about as best 20 minutes as we saw in the first half?
Absolutely. We were good on both ends. And I'm just going to tell you, you heard me in the locker room, I expect every three we shoot to go in,
right?
Because I see it in practice. So you know, I'm awfully happy for Malik. Malik, you know, after Thursday's game, Malik was in here till about 1 o'clock in the morning, in here the next morning, works on his game, wants to be good, got rewarded for his hard work put in. Listen, I didn't know what we'd do in a stretch. After losing two in a row, now we've won four in a row. And so, but we also now know we've got three in a row on the road now. And so this is a great opportunity this week to get better. We'll watch film on Monday. We'll get better and see where it goes.
All right, well, congratulations, Coach, and let's do that. Let's talk to Malik here.
Right, sounds good. Thank you, buddy.
All right, Malik. Well, talk about this for us real fast. I mean, you start off by 17 points, 3 rebounds, 7 of 9 shooting today. Overall, great team effort.
Yeah, very good. Well, very good by us. We play really good defense, everybody just across the board. So,
we'll talk about Thursday. Coach said that you stayed in the gym late Thursday. You were here early Friday morning. Offensively, you know, you've kind of been a little bit cold, but you really responded today.
Yeah, I haven't shot it well. I just figured if I get in the gym and I just work at it and the ball starts going in, my game will open up. So,
well, talk about it. I mean, the first couple go in today, you were feeling a little bit. What was that like? Knowing that you were really getting into a rhythm.
I mean, it felt good. They had to close out on me, so I got to drive a little bit more. I didn't have to see as much on the defensive end from another team, so it was a lot more one-on-one since I was making shots. So, I mean, it was good.
As a team, how did it feel, though, those first 20 minutes? Knowing, I mean, you guys, it seemed like every pass, every defensive stand, everything you were doing, you guys were in the right spot.
Oh, it felt great. It was like just all 10 guys, 10, 11 guys we played. It was just top to bottom. Everybody got in the stands, played. It was just awesome. It gave up, what, like 14
yeah,
or something?
14 points.
I mean, I've never been on a team that done that, so, I mean, it was fun. I don't know.
Well, talk about going forward. It doesn't get any easier here. You know the Gulf South Conference in and out. Now you go on the road. Talk about the momentum, though, this one carries with you.
Oh, it's huge. It's, every win matters, especially around now. So the more you can just rack up and get in a good rhythm is always good.
Well, congratulations on the win, and hopefully this one continues for you as well.
Yes, sir. Appreciate you.
It's Malik Cookstroop. I mean, what an offensive night he had tonight. Putting in a lot of work after Thursday's game, spent a lot of extra time in the gym getting some shots up, Steve. And you know what, as a shooter, that's what you got to do. You got to keep shooting, whether it's game, practice, or on your own, and it's worked for Malik.
It really has. That'll wrap up our coverage here from the stable as we'll move over to the VBC. Get ready for some Havoc hockey coming up in about an hour and 15 minutes. We'll turn things over to ESPN Radio, and we'll talk to you in about an hour and 15.
Yards, but a few minutes ago, he rushed 20 yards for a touchdown. Also, he rushed for the two-point conversion. So far, Watson today has rushed six times for 35 yards passing.